Go to the Modules section. We upload out zip file of the module. Wait while the module is authenticated and proceed with the install. Let's configure the module. Click the Add button to add a new block. In this example, we will configure custom content for an individual product. The module is fully compatible with multi-store, multi-language, and multi-currency. This example will go into great details for these functionalities. The module integrates the most common hooks, but it's also possible to specify your own custom hook to display your content. For this example, we will use a hook inside of our module list. Choose which customer group is able to view the content. In here, you are able to choose which shops will this block be assigned to. Let's just show the content in shop 2. Keep the toggle set to no in the field Use Static Content in order to choose which products are affected by this block. Now, let's go to add our custom content individually to each product. Choose a product and click on it to edit. Since our block was configured for Shop 2, let's move to Shop 2. Go to the Modules tab to configure our content. Here you can see all the blocks created that affect this product. Let's pick the one we just created. Add your custom content, keep in mind what language you are editing your product on. Click the Save button. Let's add our custom content for this product in Spanish. Click the Save button. If we switch to Shop 1, you will notice that only this block disappears as it was only configured for Shop 2. Only one block is available for this product in Shop 1. Let's view our content in the front office of Shop 2. Notice that we are in Shop 2 and the language is English. Refresh the page to load our content. Our edited product is product ID 19. Let's search for it. Here you can see the custom content for this product. If we switch language, you'll be able to view that content as well. Here is our content for Shop 2 in Spanish displayed correctly. If we switch to Shop 1, you will see that there is no content added for this product as this was not configured during the creation of the block. Let's configure our module. In this dashboard, you will be able to view your blocks created, along with important information regarding your blocks. Let's edit this block and explain some of the key features of the module. One key feature that every user should keep in mind is where is their content going to be shown. The module has a list of available hooks. You can choose from your customer groups in order to specify who sees the content. You can choose to use static content for all the products affected for this block or custom content for each individual product. You can add your custom HTML content. Be aware that this involves high understanding of HTML, CSS, and inline classes. In order to make high-level configurations, the user must have deep understanding of operators. Consult the documentation for detailed information. In this particular example, the operator between will be used. This filter will be applied to final product prices between $12 and $20, or your default currency. Click the Save button. As you can see, the extra block was added correctly based on the final price filter added. Let's create another content block in the back office. In this example, we will use the like operator to target products by their reference. Choose our hook, which is where our content will be displayed. Our block will be available for all customer groups. In this example, we will target everything that contains our keyword, both in front of and after, if it applies. Activate the block and save it. Let's disable the block that we are not using for now. Let's check which products will be affected in our product list. These products are those who have the keyword demo_1 inside their reference. The product ID is shown in the URL when we hover over it with the mouse. Based on our block configurations, the affected products will be those that contain somewhere in the reference the keyword demo_1. Let's verify a product that should not be affected. Copy and paste the name to search for it in the back office. As you can see, the product's reference does not have the keyword demo_1 anywhere in it. Let's add another block which will be for specific products identified by their ID. Choose our customer groups that will have access to the block. Add our dummy content. For this example, the IN operator will be used and the targeted product IDs will be separated by a comma. Add the product ID values for this block. This same block could have been configured using the between operator just by specifying the start and end value, separating it with a dash. Activate the block and click the save button. This block will be displayed inside the product description since the hook chosen for it is only displayed there. Let's hover over the products to find one of the product IDs we specified. As you can see, the block content was displayed correctly. Let's switch to product ID 7, which was one of the products in our list. Once again, the content was displayed correctly. Here is another of the products affected by our block.